Another variation is that overflow occurs. So by overflow, we mean, you know, we write it new beyond the point that this variable getting written has been allocated space. So I said data also gets allocated on the heap in a program. So long-lived data, for example, global variables and so on, get stored on the heap. So one crucial difference between the heap and stack is that heap does not have a return address. So you cannot hijack the control flow of the program and take it someplace where you have your own code or a library function for return to libc kind of attacks. But in the heap, we do have function pointers, depending on what kind of language and you know, how they implement it and so on. So data can be these tables of function pointers, and there you can modify a function pointer. And by doing that, you can transfer control. It's actually a lot harder than the stack buffer overflows we're talking about. Heap overflows require sort of more sophisticated in some sense and require more work. But you can, by modifying, figuring out where a certain function is and modifying the function pointer, you can transfer control to somewhere else where this new address that you place in the function pointer points to. So heap overflows, again, we corrupting memory in some sense as we did before, but this happens to be a memory that is in the heap part of the address space.